Hello everyone, Qsan is here again. Welcome in the second part about rulers. Today, let's try the advanced ones, the ruler pen, the special ruler, the guide, and last, the symmetrical ruler. Of course, with clips to the paint. In the previous video, I showed you the basic rulers and how you can use them to create easy materials and objects. In the second video, I drew some elements in the background like plants, Shiba, books, the wave on the wall using the advanced rulers. Let's start with the first one, the ruler pen. The ruler pen is one of the most dynamic rulers in the program. Moving the pen around the sketch, you'll be able to make a ruler or more that is fully editable using Tool, Operation, Object. Editing the arc or points, you can adapt the ruler line as you prefer, following your illustration. As you can see in Tool property, there are no specific options, but by checking and unchecking the Create at Editing layer, you can create a ruler in the current layer or in a new one. The post-correction allows you to fix the ruler automatically. Let's try to make the cutie Shiba in Aria Arms. Specifically for pets, plushies and character art, the ruler is really helpful and comfortable, helping you to make lines correctly without any additional steps. Once you have put the ruler around the sketch, go to Tool, GPen to make the defined line. Done! Next one is the special ruler. The special ruler has a lot of useful functions, giving you the ability to create lines, curves, and circles following the guide. Go to Tool, Special Ruler, Tool Property. In the right, you can see different ruler options. Let's start with the first one. The parallel line lets you create multiple parallel lines following the guide orientation. If you have to do some repeated lines with the same angle, this one will be perfect to you. As always, you can decide the angle of the ruler in the canvas by checking and unchecking the step of angle. With the Create at Editing layer, you can create the ruler in the same layer are you working on, or in a different one. Going to Parallel Curve, you can create a straight ruler, a spline ruler, or quadratic bezier ruler. The main difference between the spline and the quadratic bezier one is the arc or point. In the first one, I have only point. In the second one, I have red guidelines that I can move in the canvas, adapting the curve on the drawing. The multiple curve is really similar to the previous one, with the following difference. By moving the arcor points, the ruler rotates and overlaps on itself, creating a warping effect of the guidelines. The radial line is perfect when making balloons and special effects on your comics and emotional illustrations. The guide lets you create some radial lines around a point. The radial curve has the same effect, but you can create curves around the point following the guideline. The concentric circle is similar to the parallel ruler. With this, you can create multiple circles following the concentric ruler. This is perfect to draw elements and materials with a circle shape, or to add some circle lines effects to your art. Where I can use this special ruler in the drawing? With them, I'm making some tiny objects like books in the library using the parallel ruler. They are close and small in the background, therefore this ruler can help me to make smaller details. The multiple curve is perfect to make the abstract wave in the wall. It will be more easy to draw this, obtaining a perspective effect. The guide ruler, you can find in the special ruler too, lets you create a grid using only vertical and horizontal guides. This one is really simple to use without any specific option, is perfect to do something easy like grids or background patterns. Thank you. The symmetrical ruler is one of the most helpful rulers in Clip Studio Paint. It lets you create a lot of patterns, decorations, objects, and abstract shapes to decorate your character art. I used it a lot in one of my previous videos about patterns and decorations, but let me go into details this time. In the tool property, the number of lines adds two or more symmetrical guides in the canvas. Changing the value, you can create different drawings combination with easy and fun. By unchecking the line symmetry, you'll be able to create a drawing in two parts of the canvas without keeping the linear symmetry. Instead of angle, you can decide the angle of the ruler in the canvas. I'll use this ruler to create some details in the perspective background, like plants, pattern for the carpet, and abstract posters. That I'll add them in the perspective using the mesh transformation tool. These are the advanced rulers that Clip Studio Paint offer in the program. They are so useful and amazing, perfect for any type of drawing. But if you go in the sets, you can download Qsan rulers created by the community. There are infinite combinations, totally new or some similar to the standard ones with different settings. One of my favorites is the isometric ruler. Download it and once finished, drag and drop the ruler in the canvas. As you can see, the ruler is ready to be used immediately. Done! I hope this video is helpful for you to use the advanced rulers for making materials and drawing parts. In the next step, I'll complete the line art illustration making the background with the most useful guide, the perspective ruler. I'll be waiting for you. Thank you very much for watching and see you in the next video. Bye!